From the greenhouse at Greenup County High School, this is the 63rd District Boys Championship game between the Raceland Rams and the Lewis County Lions. Hello, everybody. This is Hank Bond. Thanks for joining us here on GreenupBeacon.com and the OLBH Greenup Beacon Media Network. We're bringing you all the exciting play-by-play and video action here from the greenhouse at Greenup County. We had a chance to talk to both coaches prior to the game. We'll start out with Coach Bob Trimble of the Raceland Rams, and then we'll have a moment with Joe Hampton, the head coach at Lewis County. We'll step away and be back in a minute with that on the OLBH Greenup Beacon Media Network.
My first jobs was working at AK Steel. I went on to serve our country as a captain in the Army. And I'm honored to have been your judge for 29 years. Now, I'm running for state representative so we can bring good-paying jobs back to our region, improve our schools, and take on the devastating drug epidemic that is plaguing our communities. I'm Lou Nichols, and I'm asking for your vote in the March 8th special election. Paid for by Lou Nichols for state representative.
Our emphasis has always been on first-name friendly service with a hometown touch. We know you, and you know us. Hometown people helping each other grow. We're here to serve all your banking needs. First and People's Bank and Trust Company, member FDIC. We are the home office.
Stultz Pharmacy is now offering patients compounding for their prescription needs. Stultz Pharmacy is the only pharmacy in the area PCCA certified. We can provide you with hormone replacement, neuropathy creams, scar creams, pediatric prescriptions, and we can even help you with your veterinarian needs. If you have any questions, please call 606-834-1052. That's 834-1052. Stultz Pharmacy in Greenup, Flatwoods, and Wheelersburg. More than you expect from a pharmacy.
Stultz Pharmacy.
The Hoopers, the all-star family, with dad, mom, son, grandpa, and baby, with a good neighbor right next door, a system that would like with so much more.
Coach Bob Trimble with the Raceland Rams. And Bob, first, let's back up a couple days. Big win over Greenup County.
No questions. Big for our kids, big for our program, big for our community. Backyard rivals, and it's always good to get that win.
I noticed that you had a nice mix. Davidson played really well for you. Mm-hmm. Potter came off the bench and gave you some good minutes, too.
Right. We played 10 kids that night, so we got good minutes from everybody. And our bench has been a plus for us all year. I expect that to be a positive tonight.
I saw you lose by a point to Lewis down at your house.
Right.
We did the streaming that night. Tell me just a little bit about what you expect from Joe's team.
Yeah, Joe's team's going to play hard. They've played a lot more zone this year than they have in the past, but he's been playing a lot more man here lately, so it'll be interesting to see defensively what he does. They're going to play hard. They're going to be hard-nosed. They're going to try to post their guards, drive the ball, and just be an aggressor, and it's our job to try to take that away from them.
Well, I wish you good luck, and it'd be okay to keep it in Greenup County for me.
No question.
All right,
appreciate the coverage.
Thank you, Bob.
All right.
I go to Ashland Community and Technical College.
Because it's so close.
I go.
For the small class sizes.
I go.
Because I can transfer my credits.
I go because
I can take classes when it works for me.
I go to get a better job.
I go for some of Kentucky's most affordable tuition.
I go because it's crazy not to.
For all the right reasons, Ashland Community and Technical College. Higher education begins here.
The Hearing Center at 1505 Carter Avenue in Ashland is the tri-state premier audiology center. The Hearing Center staff has been providing quality hearing and hearing aid services to Eastern Kentucky, Southern Ohio, and Western West Virginia since 1972. The Hearing Center offers four styles of hearing aids that professionals tailor to each patient's personal needs. The Hearing Center, 1505 Carter Avenue in Ashland. Phone 606-324-0465. Coach Joe Hampton of Lewis County. And Coach, big win over Russell, of course. It's always good to get to this final game.
Absolutely.
And Coach Trimble had a big upset, that double overtime win. Good for his program and bad for Harold's, of course.
Right.
But tonight, you got to look at them to try to take the championship. You beat them by a point the last time you played them. So what do you do differently tonight to make sure you maintain?
Well, we're going to mix it up maybe a little bit. I think they were pretty – we played a ton of zone earlier in the year, and I think they were waiting on that and made some great adjustments in their lineup to combat our zone, and they shot it very well. And we were a little flat. I'm not taking anything away from them, but we're going to mix it up a little bit defensively tonight, hopefully try to keep them back on their heels, guessing a little bit how we're going to play. And I feel like we've played both man and zone enough this year that we should be confident in it. So we're really going to try to find our way and see which one does best for us. And we'll throw that mixture out there until we figure it out.
And I'm sure you'll be glad to go on to Moorhead next week. I guess you'll play Wednesday or Thursday.
Right.
And that all takes place in the morning, I suppose.
Yes, I think this region's been so crazy, and there's even been upsets along the way already in the district first round. So just
now, ever thought Fairview beat Ashland by 20?
Exactly.
I mean, not that they could not a good team. It's just
nobody expected it.
Basis of what's going on.
And you got Greenup out at Greenup already, so you know that's there's a lot of things that people didn't expect. And
right.
I think just getting to Moorhead, everybody, if you get there, you got a chance. That's what I've discussed with several other coaches and people that we've talked to, that getting there, you got a chance, no matter who it is. And we're glad to be one of those eight.
Heck yeah. Well, we'll be on tonight, and I hope your fans can follow. We have awful internet problems in here, but I've had several calls from Lewis County today wanting to know if we were streaming tonight.
I've got some people that I know even in Florida that are going to be watching, and they could hear you loud and clear, but they also had a few audio problems, so hopefully that's cleared up for them.
Well, we hope so. Thanks, Joe, and good luck.
All right, thank you.
Choosing the right college is a big decision. Across the region, Kentucky or West Virginia, our tuition is a best value in the area. Attend a world-class university and stay close to home with free parking. Ohio University Southern in Ironton and Proctorville. Imagine your possibilities. Enroll today. Visit ohio.edu/southern or call 740-533-4600.
as we make ready now for the announcement of the starting lineup here in the greenhouse. For those that are on with us, I apologize to the internet. It comes and goes. And Trey Mills out for Bob Tremble's Raceland Rams. Carson Christian, he's out. Tyler Morris, who patrols the lane for the Rams, he's out. Daniel Davidson and Braden, Noah Braden. About to make it his first name, Mom. Sorry about that. And now for Lewis County. Hampton County Lions. Jake Parker, number 21. Seth Wallingford out. Isaac Kelly. And the big boy, Jacob Keebler. I used to like it when they held newspapers up. It'll be Tyler Morris to jump it up against Jacob Keebler for Lewis County.
Good luck to him on his tip.
I'm telling you. Davey Anderson tosses it up. Raceland will capture it. Are they going to let him throw it up again? Maybe he thought they could jump higher, Keith. And this one can be touched twice in the circle. That's Kelly out front. Isaac Kelly drives, pops from eight. No good. Rebound. Keebler spins, puts it up. It's blocked by Morris. We'll go the other way. No score. 30 seconds into the district final. Three. No good. Rebound. Lewis County. Walker comes off with it. 1-on-4. He'll stop. Seth Wallingford wanted a shot but didn't take it. Over on the right side, it's Walker. Parker with it now. Wallingford. Parker, shot, three, good, and it's 3-0 Lewis County, and we're underway. Double team coming up, threw that one away, one-handed pass, got him on that one. Parker against Christian, puts it up and in, and there's a bunny, Davidson puts it up and in, 5-2. And so it's Lewis County's offense. Keebler out at the top of the key. He bounces it right. Jake Parker with it. Right side. I think that's Parker. It was no good. Rebound more. That pass intended out there for Navy Christian. Kind of blocked me off on that. Inside, tapped around, Keebler keeps it. 5-2, Lewis leads it, he kicks it out. 3, no good, missed it all. Kelly couldn't get it to go down, here comes Trey Mills. Knocked away, Morris down the lane, kicks it left. Christian in the corner, goes to Davidson. Braden down the lane, lays it up, and rolls in. So a big one there for Noah Braden. And it's 5-4. Right side, Seth Wallingford. 3, no good. Ribs off. Braden saves it. Ahead to Trey Mills. Braden. Morris. Morris not in there. Rebound inside. Davidson gives it out. Kicks it right. Braden tried to bounce it to Morris low. Couldn't go. Puts it up. Spins around. Lays it in. And it's 6-5 now for Lewis County. Or for Raceland over Lewis County. Parker, Keebler with it out front. Went to Trenton Walker, he lost a handle on it. And it'll be Raceland's ball out of bounds. 3:56 to play, quarter one. So 4 minutes of the 63rd district final has passed, and it's 6-5. Raceland with the lead. Nice steal. Trenton Walker all the way down. Puts it up. Tried to dunk it. Couldn't. Comes off, but he gets the bucket. It rolled in. Trey Mills takes it in from Carson Christian. He's picked up by Seth Wallingford. It comes back to Christian. Over on the right side, Braden. Baseline, it goes over to Davidson. Davidson, he kicks it back to Christian. Out front, Trey Mills. He gets defensive pressure from Wallingford. That's Morris. Underneath it goes. Fake to Braden. Picked up Davidson. Oh, I'm sorry, Christian. Knocked away Isaac Kelly. And inside is going to be Braden. Puts it up and in. Oh, well, coach. There you go, too. Wallingford down in the corner. Isaac Kelly to Keebler. Walker, nice scoop, lays it up, draws a foul against Carson Christian. First foul of the game, we'll see Octavius Hall check in. First one up, no good. 8-7. So Jake Parker will have his second shot at it, and he can tie it at 8, and it's on the way. Good. So we're tied at 8, 2:46 to play. Couple lead changes. First tie. Missed the pass on the inside. Over here, Kelly. Bounce inside. Braden takes it away. And we go up the other way. Braden, right side. shot, no good. Rebound, Lewis County's Wallingford. Ahead to Trenton Walker, drives all the way down. Block on Nathaniel Davidson. I don't think anybody on the Raceland side much liked that call. But nonetheless, it was called a charge or a block, and that makes it Walker at the line. Hits it 9-8. Pressure from Lewis County. Austin Clark with the ball in the back court. Stolen away. Lead pass. Isaac Kelly couldn't get his hands on it. 9-8. Okay, seems like we're set. Football pass, Braden, too deep. That play didn't work twice now. Kelly, Walker, Jake Parker against Octavius Hall. They drive. He lost a handle on it. Hall tried to bounce pass it to Clark. He couldn't get to it. The circle it goes. I don't know who 11 is, Keith. That's a new number for me. Oh no, that's Bryce Wallingford. Inside, Jeremy McCann. He shoulders his way in. We're going to count the bucket. That makes it 11-8, and a free throw for Jeremy McCann in for Joe Hampton. District finals. From the greenhouse, down. Tyler Morris with it out front, inside. Braden almost threw it away. Hall gets it, kicks it over. Morris bounce pass inside to Braden. Braden can't get a handle on it. And Raceland turns it over. Now, by my count, Keith, that's five turnovers, three of them that way. And we're going to see, that's Porter, I believe. Riley Porter. Keith Atkins on camera tonight. We'll be in Moorhead for the boys regional next week. This year we're not going to be able to do the girls, but we'll start Wednesday night. Three short, rebound. Chase Thomas, Octavius Hall, gives it over. Hall. Thomas. He sets a pick. Morris short on the baseline. Gets his own. Puts it up. Won't fall. Rebound Thomas. Morris up and in. Foul on who? 32 on Morris. 23. Morris, I guess. After the shot, I guess. I'm at a loss. Shot up and in by Trenton Walker. And that's the end of the quarter. We'll be back in a minute on the OLBH Green at Beacon Media Network.
You're a hard man to find tonight.
We doing all right?
First jobs was working at AK Steel. I went on to serve our country as a captain in the Army. And I'm honored to have been your judge for 29 years. Now, I'm running for state representative so we can bring good-paying jobs back to our region. In the March special election, paid for by Lou Nichols for state representative.
I go to Ashland Community and Technical College.
Because it's so close.
I go.
For the small class sizes.
I go. Because I can transfer my credits.
I go because
I can take classes when it works for me.
I go to get a better job.
I go for some of Kentucky's most affordable tuition.
I go because it's crazy not to.
For all the right reasons, Ashland Community and Technical College. Higher education begins here.
We're in now quarter number two of the 63rd District Boys Championship. Tyler Morris drives down. I knew they were going to start giving him the ball. Bounce pass, going to be a foul. I give up trying to hear Mr. Archie. I can't hear him at all. Shot up. Good! A three ties it from Tyler Morris. It is out front with Walker. Foul called. Sometimes life is just fun, Keith. You know what I'm saying? If you can't laugh. So, 13 all. Walker's second shot up. It does hit. Jump ball. Take a timeout. Back in a minute. on the OLBH Greener Beacon Media Network.
February was designated as the Heart Month to bring awareness to the population of the United States so that people can be more aware that they need to do something about risk factors to prevent heart disease.
Some of the possible signs of heart disease are shortness of breath, indigestion.
My patients to keep their hearts healthy by moving, by exercising, eating proper diet, controlling their blood pressure, controlling their cholesterol, and taking their medications correctly.
A lot of stress increases the heart disease. For those reasons, we encourage to go to take time for yourself.
Focus on hypertension as one of the risk factors that we can affect in trying to reduce death in a million hearts by 2017.
Noah Braden will be at the free throw line after the foul shot. We're tied at 14. Octavius Hall in for Riley Potter. It is Potter, right? Not Porter. Potter. Good, because I tend to call people by the wrong name and Keith never reminds me. Left side to Jeremy McCann. McCann wanted that shot, but he'll give it down. Kelly, Wallingford, Parker. Parker backs it out. In the corner, back out. Three, no good. Rebound, Raceland. Tyler Morris to Octavius Hall, quickly up. Landon Adams puts it up, no good. It's gonna be a foul on Morris. Bad foul there. It was a true foul though. At least I can say, Keith, that tonight these fellas are calling over the back. But they're calling it, both ends. It's not a one-way. Should be a charge. It was. Trenton Walker lowered that shoulder. So, let's see, six fouls against Raceland, four fouls against Lewis County. Most of those fouls are centered around a couple players, though. Hall, Adams, down on the baseline to Braden, back to Adams. Adams down, kicks it. Is that going to be a charge? It is. See Clark in. So Adams picks up his third foul out of seven. And with that, down underneath, no good. Clark, little hand on that one. No good. Rebound, Lewis County. And we'll come back the other way. Quickly Walker with it down in the lane. Three, no good. Rebound, Octavius Hall. And the Rams take it and go the other way. Hall back out to Mills. Handle that ball. Almost turned it over, caused Trenton Walker to pick up a foul. Now, And then it comes to Hall. Hall, Austin Clark, cross courts it to Mills. Got a short lineup in there except for Morris, and he has it blocked out of bounds. Nice block. Fourteen-all, 4:35 to play in the first half. And so with that, we're back to action. On the floor, tapped around, picked up. On the floor, touch left. Offensive foul with the elbow. No doubt about it, could have called a technical. Because they called that technical on Lakey that night. Hall, corner, Mills, three, too long. Rebound, Lewis County, still tied at 14. An amazingly low scoring first half. Jake Parker. Some of that's defense, though, isn't it? 5 second turnover. Hall with it out front. Bounce pass in, Braden. Reverse layup, old days. Keith Atkins shot, and we're 16-14, Raceland. What a great game, a lot of great defense out there. Officiating not taking over the game. Kelly. That's Bryce Wallingford inside, stolen away. Behind him on the floor, Wallingford, jump ball. It'll come back to Lewis County. Offensive foul called against Jake Parker. Hey, coach. Consistent. I don't have any issue with that. Full court pressure. Almost stolen. Could have been another foul. Morris in the corner. Clark. Out front, Octavius Hall. Hall goes right behind a back dribble, kicks it over. That's Landon Adams. Morris inside, Braden back out. Landon Adams up two, 2:22 to play. First half, could have got a foul right there and didn't. All the way down, he walked. And they're gonna put Trey Mills back in. Adams will go to the bench. And with that, we'll say hello to our fans that I know are watching in Vanceburg and also watching up in northern Kentucky and down in Florida and Georgia. Those I know about for sure. Again, we will carry the boys' 16th region basketball tournament, and we'll have a full timeout now, back in a minute here on the OLBH Green of Beacon Media Network. Great crowd on hand here at the Greenhouse for the finals of the 63 Boys District Basketball Tournament. Last night, Russell with a win over Lewis County in the girls action, and they'll advance to start play on Monday or Tuesday in the 16th Region Tournament at LST Johnson Arena. There's a layup from Jake Parker, and that tied it. 16, 2 minute mark. 2 minute warning, only they don't have that in basketball. Here comes Lewis County. Shot in the lane, up, no good, foul. So Parker puts it up, good. 17-16, Lewis County. Tied at 8 at the half, at the quarter. Second one's good, 18-16. West Carter 22, Elliott County 16 in the second quarter. Boyd 21, Fairview 18 in the first quarter. And right now, that's all I can give you. Hall. In the corner. Minute 13 to go. Hall out front, three, no good. I might consider going inside with that one, I think. But he didn't. McCann 1-3. 14-footer, no good. Rebound Lewis, Keebler kicks it back out. Bad news for the Rams. I think that's three. Well, that's only his second. So a while ago, you were right, but he was wrong. You were right, he was wrong. Bryce Wallingford out. At the half now, it's West Carter 29, Elliott 25. Second one good. Now it's 20 to 16, 19, I guess. 25 seconds to play here in the first half. And we'll come the other way. Going to put in Chase Thomas for Tyler Morris here in these last seconds, simply because they don't want to take a chance. Lewis County 19, Graceland 16. We'll be back in a few minutes here on the OLBH Green Beacon Media Network.
Super Quick owns Subways. You can buy 3 footlongs, $5 each, or a regular salad for $5, or mix and match any 3 salads or footlongs for $15.
Available only at these Super Quick Subways: Cannonsburg, Greenup, Cerrito, Ironton, Colgrove, South Point, Vanceburg, and Flatwoods.
Subway, eat fresh.
February was designated as the Heart Month to bring awareness to the population of the United States so that people can be more aware that they need to do something about risk factors to prevent heart disease.
Some of the possible signs of heart disease are shortness of breath, indigestion, unusual sweating,
chest pain, chest pressure, dizziness, just pain between their shoulder blades.
I always tell my patients to keep their heart healthy by moving, by exercising, eating proper diet, controlling their blood pressure, controlling their cholesterol, and taking their medications correctly.
A lot of stress increases the heart disease. For those reasons, we encourage to go to take time for yourself.
Focus on hypertension as one of the risk factors that we can affect in trying to reduce death in a million hearts by 2017.
Choosing the right college is a big decision. Ohio University Southern offers more than 30 degree and certificate programs. Whether you're in Ohio or just across the river in Kentucky or West Virginia, our tuition is a best value in the area. Attend a world-class university and stay close to home with free parking. Ohio University Southern in Ironton and Proctorville. Imagine your possibilities. Enroll today. Visit ohio.edu/southern or call 740-533-4600.
Heavenly Father, I'm to Chavez. I pray for peace and joy in mind, body and spirit, and for the hope of this day. In your name, amen.
And we're ready for second half action here at the Greenhouse. Ball will belong to the Raceland Rams to begin quarter number three. So it's true, Keith. There's one person that likes you. Oh, family? You know, I haven't seen you in 3 years, but you're still related. I got you. Okay. Here we go. Trey Mills with it out front. Bounce pass Carson Christian, and we're underway. 19-16. Lewis County led at the half. That's Braden. Spins. Throws it up. Too hard. Rebound Keeble. Third quarter will be a big thing, I think. It could be a decider here. What do you think? Three. There's a decision maker. 22-16. Pass. Braden. There's Rebecca. Morris cuts it to four, 22-18. Right corner, Kelly, short. Rebound, Raceland. Morris kicks it over, Trey Mills quickly to Braden. Braden's gonna wait on him, goes out front, Christian. Christian, free throw line, kicks it to the corner to Davidson. And it's Christian back with it, gets a pick from Morris, he'll back it out. Underneath, Christian has it blocked. He was waiting on that one, Dad. All the way down. Parker up. No good. Keeper with the rebound. Fouled on the shot by Nathaniel Davidson. Keeper at the line. Puts it up. No good. ...22-18, Lewis on top. 5:59 to play. 5-point game now with the free throw. Morris tapped out Walker. Daniel Davidson in the corner, 5:43 to play. Raceland patient, looking for an opportunity. Came off of Wallingford and the fans erupted, but he smiled. It came off his foot, is what happened. Christian, Paul out front. Down in the corner, Morris. Absolutely no internet tonight. Not sure why. Davidson puts it up. He's fouled. Parker took too many steps. They're going to call a foul. Should have been a walk going on. ...23-18. Biggest lead of the night, 7. Time out on the floor. We'll be back in a minute here on the OLBH Green of Beacon Media Network.
The Hearing Center at 1505 Carter Avenue in Ashland is the Tri-State Premier Audiology Center. The Hearing Center staff has been providing quality hearing and hearing aid services to Eastern Kentucky, Southern Ohio, and Western West Virginia since 1972. The Hearing Center offers 4 styles of hearing aids that professionals tailor to each patient's personal needs. The Hearing Center, 1505 Carter Avenue in Ashland, phone 606-324-0465.
A 6-2 run has given Lewis County a 25-18 lead with 5:05 to play in quarter number 3 here in the 63rd District Boys Final Tournament. 63rd District Tournament Final. Final Tournament. Something. Christian down. Has it knocked out of his hands. .455 to play. Over it goes to Octavius Hall. He goes to Braden. Braden has the move, stops, takes it in the lane, kicks it. Christian wanted a 3, didn't take it. Down the lane, in the corner, 3! Good! 25-21. I think I enjoy that, you know? Is that why you chuckle at me every time? I'm not allowed to have fun, right?
Yeah.
I especially like it when you roll your eyes. Down the lane, knocked out. I heard that. My kids didn't do that too much to me. Oh, yeah. I thought you meant your kids. Nice shot, Parker. Comes up short. Tapped around. Raceland has it. Braden, Hall. Hall will not shoot it. His job's to handle that ball. In the corner, Braden. He gets a nice move over there. Morris was going to set a pick, but I believe they'd have called a foul, had he. And so we'll keep the ball down in there. Potter. Good. Nice shot there by Riley Potter. Cuts it down to a 2-point game, 25-23. Could have been a foul right there. Inside, Keever couldn't get his hand on it. You know, the other night against Raceland, or against Russell, he was so sure-handed. Tonight he's had trouble with it. Well, it is a difference. Hall goes to the floor. Yes. And so Jeremy McCann will check in. Side, Christian up, good. Nice move by Carson Christian, and we're tied at 25. So that's a nice run. That's a 9-point run. 9-2, I guess. McCann goes up with it. Foul inside, going to be on Potter, I believe. Two shots. Chris Mullins will be leaving Greenham County High School as the head football coach. He's accepted the head post at Lexington Dunbar. On the way, good. 7-0 run by Raceland tied it. Now Lewis back out by two. Christian, bounce pass across. Shot, no good, rebound. Raceland, that was Potter. Wallingford. Gonna be a foul. Shot up and in, makes it a three-point game. And a four-point game as Jake Parker nails two. Down the sideline, Hall kicks it down in the corner, back out front, Morris. Hall. Christian. Braden, he'll keep it out front. Caught up and in. 29-27. Across the top, Parker, double team, one-handed shovel, over to Walker, back out to Parker with a minute 12 to play, 29-27, low scoring affair, a long press row, someone said a while ago, first team to 40 wins it, I almost believe that. Jeremy McCann with it out front, right side it goes Walker. Walker drives, puts it off the glass and in. I believe I'd have had to foul him, Keith. 31. Line Walker, good. Potter, should have been a foul and was. Seconds. That out of time. 6 seconds. Hall with three. No good. Rebound. Braden up and in. Noah Braden gets the bucket. Did it count it? 31-29. We're at the end of three. Back in a minute on the OLBH Green to Beacon Media Network.
Our emphasis has always been on first-name friendly service with a hometown touch. We know you, and you know us. Hometown people helping each other grow. We're here to serve all your banking needs. First and People's Bank and Trust Company, member FDIC. We are the home office.
Hometown people, hometown spirit.
Stultz Pharmacy is now offering patients compounding for their prescription needs. Stultz Pharmacy is the only pharmacy in the area PCCA certified. We can provide you with hormone replacement, neuropathy creams, scar creams, pediatric prescriptions, and we can even help you with your veterinarian needs. If you have any questions, please call 606-834-1052. That's 834-1052. Stultz Pharmacy in Greenup, Flatwoods, and Wheelersburg. More than you expect from a pharmacy.
Stultz Pharmacy.
Final 8 minutes of the 63rd District Boys Tournament Final. 31-29, Lewis leads it by two. As we move on now to the final 8 minutes of regulation, Keith says no overtime. Lewis County gets it for the beginning of the quarter, and they miss it. Racel with a chance to tie. Hall brings it up, double team, comes over. Down the lane, Morris tapped from behind. Keeber takes it, goes to the floor. Football pass, Kelly threw it up wildly, but he'll get two free throws. Boyd County 60, Fairview 50 after three.
People need to realize we don't get paid by the hour.
Huh?
People need to know we don't get paid by the hour.
We don't get paid by the hour? No. That's why you root for no fouls.
No fouls, no timeouts.
And a shortened halftime. At the end of three, it's Elliott County 47, West Carter 46. So it's going to be an exciting end to the night. I don't think Elliott County's won that district in probably 15 years. Won the region, but didn't win the district. Christian throws a football pass out of bounds. And it's a three-point lead for Lewis County. Trenton Walker across the timeline. There's Wallingford, hits it. 34-29, now back out to a five-point lead. And for whatever reason, again, we've stopped off. Going to be a foul underneath. Only two. I still can't quite figure out why where we are. We can't get internet, but doesn't work. In the corner, out front, Potter. Across the top, he'll give it to Trey Mills. Christian with it out front. Three, no good. She came up short. Potter gets it out to Morris. Morris throws it out. Carson Christian down the lane. I don't know where he was going with that one, but it wasn't over there, right? And so with all that, 5-point lead for Lewis County. In the corner, that's Wallingford, that's Bryce. Out front, Walker in the lane. And now it's a 7-point lead once again. Pressure, timeout Raceland. I'd say it's a full timeout. So we'll step away and be back in a minute here on the OLBH Green at Beacon Media Network.
Heavenly Father, thank you for today. Thank you for the opportunities it holds for growth, learning, and enjoyment, and for the time to share with others. I pray for peace and joy in mind, body and spirit, and for the hope of this day. In your name, amen.
Around the corner or around the world with the Green Up Beacon.
Seven-point lead for Lewis County. Final 6:05 of regulation to be played here. Full court pressure from the Lions. Triple team the ball, but that opens up a lot. Braden open down in the corner. Pressure, kicks it to Braden. Drives, kicks it over. Morris up, no good. Rebound, 5-4, Lewis. Trenton Walker comes out with it. Down, stops, pops from four. It'll count. And he draws a foul from Austin Clark. Stolen away. Walker shot up. Foul. You know, Keith, he might have hacked him, but he didn't push him. They're calling a push, and there was no more push than you down there. Walker hits the first one. 10-point, now 11-point lead. Octavius Hall checks in for Austin Clark. Looks like a handful to me. He was fouled by Walker. But that's only four on Lewis County. And with that, four on the team. And so it's 5:35 to play. Inside, turned over. Seth Wallingford. Kelly, no good. Rebound, Morris. Football pass. Down to Davidson. Davidson stops over Parker. No good. And he's fouled. Exactly. Exactly. First one up. Good. So Keith got to go to the Paramount today to see science in action. They didn't drive you through Burger King, did they? Rolled in there. So, with 5:20 to play in this one, 10-point lead for the Lewis County Lions. Down the lane, shot up, good. Lewis County salting this one away now. Out by 12. Raceland needs a couple buckets and some stops. Three, no good. Fought for, rebound. Morris got it back on the floor, rolls around with it. Bryce Wallingford, down the floor goes Trenton Walker, puts it up and in. And a foul. Called a technical foul on somebody. I say he called him something. So a 14-point game, and you think? I'm guessing. I guess it was on Octavius Hall. I didn't really couldn't see the. Bobby Trimble might get one too. .30 seconds. So he's out. Landon Adams checks in. Parker, no good. Second one, good. 46-31. It was 31-29 at the half, so that's a 15-2 quarter. Side, stolen away. Daniel Davidson. Foul on Wallingford. .46-31. Raceland will play it in. There it is out front. Christian down the lane, puts it up. Good. And he draws a foul on Keebler. Sometimes it amazes me how they never foul. You ever notice that? Shot up, no good. Rebound, Raceland. Davidson. I guess they called a foul. I'm not sure. So, Davidson at the line. I will apologize once again. Keebler rebounds it. So he didn't have a three-point play there. In the left. Braden ahead. And a three! Landon Adams with a triple. And it's down to 11. Who was it? Wasn't five? That's Landon Adams, I think. In the corner, Kelly. Pressure, baseline, out front, Parker. That's Parker out front to Kelly. 2:27 to play, 14-point game. Nice block, Keebler. Christian got it back in the lane. Kicks it out. Christian. That's Adams with it in the corner. Reverse layup. Braden up and in. 49-37. All right. Out for Raceland, Jacob Blair, Joseph, Josiah Blair. The way it goes, they scramble for it on the floor. Foul. Foul against Trenton Walker. I guess, yeah, Trenton Walker. Well, he's getting one plus one. There wasn't any blood. Is that what they're doing? Just a little sweat. Play. We'll upload the entire game. It'll be up and on by 10 o'clock tonight. We apologize for the, but unfortunately Greenup County can't help it, neither can we. Hits it. No good. Rebound, Lewis County. All the way down. Walker has it knocked out of his hands by Carson Christian, who draws the foul. Good. Hits it. .135 to play. Three! No good! Keebler with it, out of comes the Walker. Walker down, backs it around. Christian tries to take it away, can't, gives it to Wallingford. That's Seth. All the way down, Parker up, counts it in. He'll get the bucket. You know, he just loves to do that. Yeah. He has a chance, though, for an old-fashioned three-point play.
That's for the racing people out there.
Huh?
That's just for the racing people.
Gotcha.
They know what we're talking about.
Somebody does. We don't usually know what we're talking about, so. Correct. Hits it. So he gets the old-fashioned three-point play, and it's a 16-point lead. Just a matter of setting the final margin here, as Lewis County will represent the 63rd District as a champion over in Moorhead at the 16th Region Tournament. Parker to Walker. Time out, Lewis County. We'll step away for a minute and be back on the OLBH Green at Beacon Media Network. Point lead for the Lewis County Lions, 54-38, with a minute and one to go here on greenatbeacon.com in the finals of the boys' 63rd district tournament. Jake Parker has it. Across the timeline, he takes it down, bounce pass underneath, stops, pop, Kelly, no good, draws a foul. 53 seconds to play. Almost no matter what we've done tonight, Coach, we can't keep the internet on. No matter where it is or what it is, you know how that works. I'm not hitting. 55-38. Kelly with the second one. 18-point lead for Lewis County. Wesleyan with a 9-point fourth quarter. Three, no good. Rebound, Morris. Thought for it, comes out. Parker, 40 seconds to play. Wesleyan's gonna back up. I'm not sure I'd foul down 18, but I'm not the coach. Christian's out. Trey Mills checks back in. Of course, this is a double bonus. They're all running in some late game substitutions, and I don't blame them at all. Chase Parker at the line. That was a quick game, though, Keith. It's only 8:30. Point lead for the Lions. Second one on the way. Good. Point lead for Lewis County. Bench is empty. Trey Mills across the timeline, stops in the corner. Threw it away. Saved nicely out there. Damon Black inside Potter. Three! No good! Out of bounds. 18 seconds to go. He would have liked to have had that three, Coach, don't you think? This is where we run into rosters that don't match up with numbers when you get down this far on the bench. 10 seconds. Three. Hit it. 3-point bucket for Tommy Parks of the Lewis County Lions. That was sweet. Ball comes in. Trey Mills shoots it. Missed it. And Russell lost to Lewis County as well. 62-38, our final, as the Rams go down. Lewis County will advance as the champion of the 63rd District. And Raceland will represent the district as the runner-up. The final. Thanks for joining, Keith Atkins. This is Frank Bond. We'll be on the air next Wednesday behind the National High School Federation wall, so you'll need to check on Bunny early and get there for all the exciting action of the 16th region. For Keith, this is Frank. Have a great evening, everyone.